Very quickly, a couple definitions you should be aware of. An incident ray, this is a ray of light that travels from a light source towards a surface. In this diagram, you can see this would be my incident ray. It's heading towards the surface. In this case, sort of like a sheet of glass, a reflecting surface. A reflected ray is a ray that begins at the point where the incident ray and the normal meet. Now, a normal is sort of an invisible dotted line that's perpendicular to the reflecting surface. So once this incident ray hits the normal, you've got what's called a reflected ray continuing in this direction. Now, the law of reflection has two parts. The first is that the incident ray, the reflected ray, and the normal always lie within the same plane. So if you picture this incident ray and this reflected ray and this normal, they all kind of exist in the same three-dimensional plane. It's kind of hard to visualize two-dimensionally, but this gray rectangle here is considered the plane, and you can see that it's perpendicular to the reflecting surface. So once this incident ray hits this area, it doesn't sort of come out of the page, it continues in that plane. The second point is that the angle of reflection, which is called R with the angle symbol, is equal to the angle of incidence, which is the I angle, and this is just summarized as the reflected angle is equal to the incident angle. Okay, so in this diagram, you can see here the incident ray is coming towards the reflecting surface. Once the incident ray hits the surface, you can draw this dotted line to represent the normal. This is a 90 degree angle, right? So this is perpendicular to the reflecting surface. If you were to measure this angle of incidence, you would see that, you know, this angle here should be the same as the reflected angle. That's the second point of the law of reflection. Okay, so your angle of incidence and your angle of reflection should be equal. You can continue with your ruler drawing your reflected ray from your point of contact. And then it's always kind of just good practice to go back and label your incident ray, your reflected ray, you know, your angle of incidence and reflection, as well as your normal. Okay, so that's the law of reflection. Here's a very quick example. On your paper, make a ray diagram with the incident angle being 30 degrees. Be sure to label the incident ray, angle of incidence and reflection, and the normal. Okay, so here I've got my incident ray. The next thing I'm gonna do is just draw a normal. Here it is. If I were to use a protractor to measure my angle of incidence, let's call that 30 degrees. Using the law of reflection, I know that my reflected ray should reflect back at an angle of 30 degrees between the normal and my reflected ray. The last thing would be to label my diagram. I'm not gonna do that in this video, but you know, this is the incident ray, this is the reflected ray, this would be my angle of incidence, this would be my angle of reflection, and lastly, I've got my normal here, which is perpendicular to my reflecting surface. The last thing I want to do is just show you how to locate an image in a plane mirror using ray diagram. So plane mirror is just sort of a, you know, flat mirror. I've got an object here. You can imagine if I was on this side of the mirror looking at the mirror, I would see the reflection of this object. My goal here is to determine where that's going to be. Okay, so the first thing you're going to do is you're going to take your object. You got the tip of the object and you got the base of the object. You could label those. So this would be point A, and doesn't really matter where, it's as long as you have two points. Our goal is to sort of duplicate this object on the other side of the mirror. Okay, so I've got points A and B. First thing I'm gonna do is look at point A, and I'm gonna draw an incident ray from point A directly towards the plane mirror. Okay, and this is gonna hit directly at a 90 degree angle to the plane mirror. And you can imagine what would happen if I'd have this incident ray strike the mirror. You know, it would definitely bounce back upon itself. This is not a curved mirror. You'd just see a direct reflection at an angle of 90 degrees to the plane mirror. The next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna draw another incident ray from the tip of the object from point A toward the mirror at some angle. I'm just drawing it towards the mirror. And based on your understanding of the laws of reflection, you can probably predict what's gonna happen. So if I strike the surface, immediately I'm going to draw a normal, which is gonna be perpendicular to my surface. And you can sort of imagine that this incident ray would be reflected at an angle such that my angle of incidence, which would be this angle, should be equal to my reflected angle, which is that angle right there. You're probably thinking, okay, well, how does this help us, you know, see what's going on this side of the mirror? Well, what you can do is you can take your incident rays. In this case, I'll start with this first one, and you can extend it sort of past the mirror. You can picture if this mirror wasn't here, the ray would continue in this direction. Okay, you're gonna do the same thing with your reflected ray. Right, as if I bounce off the mirror and head this way, what would happen if we kind of backtracked and went through the mirror? Well, you'd see this sort of, you know, imaginary ray kind of traveling through the mirror in this direction. Okay, this is very, very rough and approximate, But you can see here I've got this point where these two rays intersect. What I'm going to do is just call that A prime, sort of tip of the image. The next thing you're going to do is the exact same thing with B point. So what I'll do quickly is just sort of erase all of these rays just for simplicity purposes, make this diagram a little bit simpler. Okay, so we've found A prime. What we're going to do is the same thing with B. Remember, the first thing was to take our incident ray coming directly from point B. It's going to hit the mirror. It's going to continue in the backwards direction. You can imagine that happening with just sort of a flat mirror. What we're interested in is if this ray were to continue through the mirror in this manner, right, you'd see it kind of just continue straight ahead. Just like with point A, we want to take the point B and we want to shoot a ray towards the mirror. It doesn't really matter where it hits as long as it's at an angle. Okay, so I'll kind of shoot it in this direction. And you can imagine if I had shot that ray, just quickly I'll just draw a normal. Using the law of reflection, I know that I should get a reflected ray coming from this point such that my angle of incidence and my angle of reflection are equal. And if I've got that ray and I continue this guy, you know, sort of behind the mirror, you should see it kind of look like this, kind of approximate, right? But if those angles are the same, you should see this ray sort of continue in this manner. Similar to with A prime, we want to label this new point of intersection. I'm going to call it B prime. And you can kind of see that I've got these two points on the other side of the mirror. It's not really surprising in this case that these points exist on the other side of the mirror. When you look through a mirror, you know, it's as if you're seeing the image in front of you on the other side of the mirror. What you can then do is just draw the object by connecting your B prime to your A prime points. This object should be an exact duplicate of the object that we were seeing on the right side of the mirror. Okay, it should be the same size. It should be the same distance from the mirror. Only difference is that it's inverted, what we call laterally, from left to right. Okay, this is a very kind of rough drawing here. I didn't really have scale or a ruler. You can see that, you know, they are approximately the same size. Maybe this one's a little bit smaller. Kind of looks like it's a little bit closer to the mirror. But that's the idea here. Okay, so that's how you locate an image in a plane mirror using a ray diagram. Okay, so that's the end of the video tutorial, kind of a review of the law of reflection and how you can use it to locate an image in a plane mirror. All right, thanks for watching.